Excited.
And we are here. Hello, everyone who's waiting. We have four concurrent viewers, three likes. Yeah, there we are. We're here. Hello, everyone. How's it going, guys?
Hey, hello.
Yeah, we have a Ben. Ben's normally in chat, but Ben is here live in person. Well, not in person, but...
Can't get rid of me.
You will never be free of me, Spider-Man. Ugh. I'm excited, dude. Are you excited? Are you ready for some Nintendo E3 shenanigans?
Oh, am I ever. A lot of things I'm looking forward to. A lot of things that I have to be conscious of not showing up.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I can't help you be excited nonetheless.
Oh, for sure. For sure. Hi, Tom. Hi, Ben. So, Shimia. Hello.
Hello, Shimia.
How's it going? I'm confused. We went from three concurrent viewers to zero concurrent viewers, and yet Shimia is here. I think YouTube is confused.
Okay.
Oh, YouTube. You silly beast.
As long as the video is not unlisted again,
you know, we're going to just double check that. Nope. Visibility public. It's all good.
Good.
That drove me insane, dude. That actually drove me nuts. I could not believe that nonsense.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm gonna post on Twitter that we're live.
Yeah, absolutely. 100%. Yeah, I'm gonna do the same, actually. Post in a few different places here.
Social media.
Yeah, I know. The socials.
Oh, yeah, we just did an audio test with us, but, like, how do we sound to you guys?
Yeah. Is everything sounding good? You guys feel like things are where they need to be? Anything need to be adjusted?
I would hate it if I was screaming over Tom on his own channel.
Alright. I have posted in my Discord to let the people know.
Everyone, it is starting.
Pay attention now, please.
Jamia says, just got into Skyrim, and ooh. I have to say, just browsing mods is almost as fun as playing the game.
I mean, at this point, there's such an insane library of things that you could check out in Skyrim. Absolutely insane. Hey, there's Gray. Sound good? Excellent.
Okay, perfect. Great.
And, of course, you know, when there's Nintendo things happening on screen, we'll be endeavoring to not be talking over it, but you know, yeah. We were saying this before, and I'm sure you guys could probably imagine, but there's certain things that could potentially come up during the direct today that will cause Ben and or myself to absolutely, you know, lose our gourds. So apologies. I've already said I will throw myself back away from my mic if I start screaming about Fire Emblem to try and not blow anyone's eardrums out. But
I'm gonna lean forward into my mic. Actually, I'm just gonna be like, "Oh, Metroid."
You will all know the depths of my excitement. It's like, oh, Ben is in my brain with me forever now. Understood.
The stream turned off several hours later. I can still hear his voice.
Yes, exactly. Precisely. Oh, God. Guess we won't know until it really starts. Yeah, exactly. Oh, okay, well, we've alluded to it, but what exactly is it that you're hoping to see today here, Ben? Because I'm sure people can take some ganders, but maybe there's some sleeper hits, too, that you want that we don't know about.
Number one, with a bullet, of course, Metroid Prime 4.
Yep.
I'm a huge Metroid Prime fan. It's like my favorite game besides Dark Souls, and I really want to see what they're doing with the fourth one, and I'm excited/worried because it's not the same original staff that Retro had on the first trilogy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's people have left over the years, people have gone to other companies, so...
Right.
Just different talent altogether, but...
Hmm.
they could still pull it off. You never know. Like
they certainly could. It's. I mean, I feel like it's kind of the. what's that?
Like I said, I just want to see my girl. I just want to see Samus.
Yeah, right. Exactly. It's rough because it's like, I don't want to go to 343 as an example of the way to do things well, but they do seem like they are turning things around for Infinite, which will kind of address something that Grayson asked in chat as well. But like, you can have a new team do the original game justice. It's just not easy.
Mm-hmm.
But
some of the Metroid Prime people are at 343 now. It's weird.
Oh, are they really?
Yeah.
Oh, no kidding. Interesting. Huh. I would not have expected that.
Yeah, they pick people from all over.
That's pretty cool, actually. yeah, to answer your question, Gray, there's been a bunch of interesting stuff for me. I know the general reaction and the memes have been showing that E3 has been pretty light on anything of interest to most people. But, I mean, I'm impressed with the way that they seem to, at least from a presentation standpoint, have turned Halo Infinite around compared to the state it was in last year. That, bringing on Joe Staten, who did so much work in fixing Destiny as well, was definitely a good move for them, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
But so there was that. There's a new Suikoden style game. Which did you see that, Ben?
No.
It's are you familiar with Suikoden?
Oh wait, no. Wait. I think I did see this one that you were talking about. It was kind of like Octopath looking.
Mm-hmm. And it's a spiritual successor to the Suikoden series, and which I think I'm pronouncing correctly now that I think about it, but. It's, like, made by a bunch of the members of the original team. It's going to be super cool. If you don't know in chat, Suikoden was an old series of JRPGs. I think the last one was on the PS2. That the whole, like, kind of shtick is that there's always 108 recruitable party members. And half the game is just finding them and figuring out how to get them to join you. But it's cool because they're all unique. Yeah, it's super unique. Like, they all have their own spell lists and abilities and weapon types, and a bunch of them, like, have different combo attacks together and all sorts of different stuff you can do. It's super cool. And not something that I was expecting to see, like, a revival of in any way in 2021, but here we are. So, I'm excited
kind of
for that.
Kind of past that announcement. I didn't realize they were going for Suidoken.
Is it Suidoken?
I don't know.
Ah, God.
I've only seen it written, so I've never heard anyone talk about it.
So. I say it the way my dad said it when I was a kid, and I mean, knowing my dad, he definitely was not saying it properly, but, you know, what can you do?
I think my dad said it as, what the hell is this shit? He's not like that, but he doesn't really know video games. So.
That's fair. Yeah, that's in stark contrast to my dad, who I found a lot of these JRPGs from him playing it and me watching him play it.
Oh, that's really cool.
Reading up on Suikoden now as well seems hype. Yeah, it looks super cool, and like Ben said, it uses that Octopath style that seems to be the new standard for a lot of, like, classic style JRPGs, like the remake of Dragon Quest III is using it. Yeah, there's, like, all sorts of stuff. I mean, obviously, Octopath and Triangle Strategy, like, it's just such a beautiful style. So, yeah, I'm very, very pleased. I'm very excited. That's going to be cool. Have there been any major highlights for you from E3 thus far, Ben?
Technically, it's not E3, but Elden Ring is, like, the one thing I'm looking forward to the most. And I'm so excited. The trailer looked incredible.
Yeah.
It's so much to show off.
Yeah. And I would say that falls in E3. It's kind of like, E3 has kind of gone beyond the actual expo itself, and it's basically just, like, the holiday season of gaming, right? So people just show shit because it's that time.
it does feel like the holiday season, kind of, when you say it like that.
Yeah, absolutely. Ahoy!
Oh, hey, ahoy.
What's ahoy, up?
Star.
Yeah, Star said ahoy.
Ahoy, ahoy.
Soikoden's coming back. Did Konami release the IP? Well, it's not Soikoden, but it's a spiritual successor from the original team, basically. So they can get around the IP issues and just make another one. Like, kind of like with the Left 4 Dead thing where they've got that Back 4 Blood that's, like, it's Left 4 Dead 3. They just can't call it that. But I'm sorry, you were going to say, though, Ben?
Oh, yeah, for other E3 stuff. The Square Enix thing didn't have much, but
yeah.
I want to destroy Chaos.
Mm-hmm.
Chaos needs to go. I don't know how you guys feel about Chaos, but I think he shouldn't be around anymore, and
yeah.
I kind of want to get rid of him.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Dare I say kill him? I don't. I mean, maybe that's extreme. Maybe that's extreme. I don't know.
That thing looks so cheesy, but what was it called? Strangers of...
Strangers... I think Strangers in Paradise or something. Strangers Final Fantasy Paradise. Origins. Which yeah. I'm interested in. I'm excited about. Like, it looks cool. I just... What's happening?
I don't know. I'm expecting some weird twist on it, but it looks like super 2000s edgy kind of style, which I kind of love.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Also, from the initial rumor of what Final Fantasy Origins was going to be, it's like their take on Dark Souls, which, yes, I'm entirely down for.
Mm-hmm. No, I mean, and you can definitely see that in the way that it was presented. Hey, Berserk pops in, says peek, peek, and then lurk mode. Well, enjoy the show, Berserk. What's interesting to me, like, you know, Jack's outfit notwithstanding, because did you know his name is Jack, the main character?
Yes.
Yeah, God, that's, like, so... It fits, but I'm like, wait. But from what I've seen, like, it does look like he's actually has more appropriate outfits for what I can only assume is going to be some sort of a job system. Because if you look at the trailer... Cool. Yeah, if you look at the trailer, like, at one point he's, like, throwing a spell out and he's wearing robes, and then there's another point where he's swinging the sword and he's got armor. So... It might just be, like, that's kind of your freelancer sort of outfit right at the start, and then you get different stuff as you change jobs. I don't know.
It'd be interesting, because, from my knowledge, Final Fantasy 1 didn't have jobs. You just kind of picked a class, and
right.
That was your...
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how they're going to do it.
For the Nintendo Direct, though, the other things, besides Metroid, which... would be amazing. Of course, Bayonetta 3.
Oh, God, yeah. Fun.
Anything Xenoblade. Breath of the Wild 2 would be cool.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. It's a lot of things that it's like, okay, this would be nice, but I'm not expecting it.
Right. And there's something to be said for the fact that Nintendo themselves said that the 40-minute presentation is going to be focusing primarily on stuff coming out in 2021.
Yeah, it's like, unless that's coming out this year, it's probably not going to be there.
Right. Which, like, I don't know, man, because I'm expecting a Triangle Strategy release date, but that's not coming out until 2022, so maybe not.
I could see them doing it, even though it's coming out next year.
Right. Yeah, just announcing the release date, I could see that.
Get in there.
Yeah. I can't...
Another demo.
Yeah, right.
Oh, no.
Oh, God. I can't imagine that Breath of the Wild 2 would be coming out this year. That just seems way too ambitious.
Yeah, I doubt it.
They
would have been hyping it up more.
Yeah, for sure.
Especially at the last Direct, they said, like, forget about Breath of the Wild 2. Skyward Sword port is our big game of 2021.
Exactly. What was... Oh.
Like Adventure 3, for sure happening. Shamia. Star says, well, technically the classes were jobs in Final Fantasy 1. You just didn't change them so much as got an upgrade for them.
That's
yeah,
true.
Your guy gets all, like, big caveman looking.
Yeah. No, I mean, that's true. You are correct. And it's definitely kind of like where we started to see the beginnings of the job system that really started to come into its own in 3, I want to say?
Yeah. Three was the one. That was actually the first Final Fantasy I played. The
oh, really? Yeah, no kidding.
Very retro-style game, but I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I loved it. I loved it very much. And even in 2, you kind of had the ability to designate jobs. Have you ever played 2, Ben?
No, I haven't.
It's interesting because the way your leveling works is you don't really have individual character levels. All of your different skills have levels. And you only level them by using them. So, like, your HP and your defenses only go up by getting hit. You level up your ability with different weapons or magic by using them.
Oh, right. I remember hearing something about that, yeah.
It's weird. It's interesting.
No one ever used it again.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. But I did like it, and it very much allowed you to designate, like, okay, here's a fighter, here's a black mage, here's a white mage, like, so even then they were messing with that type of idea, which I think is cool.
I got new things, even back then.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Jimmy says he just wants to raise some chow again.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's, again, I've never played, like, any of the Sonic games except OG, like, Sonic and Knuckles on the Sega Genesis. So I missed that whole boat
stuff. I hear the Chao Garden is like really addicting, but
yeah, I know Jane has talked about that because she played Sonic Adventure 3 back in the day, or Sonic Adventure 2 I should say.
So is there anything you're hoping for at the Nintendo Direct?
Oh boy, well, obviously I'm always in for some Fire Emblem. I'm not expecting a new mainline entry yet at all, but I'm hoping, I know we've discussed this in the past, Ben, I'm hoping we see a Genealogy of the Holy War remake get announced, because, I mean, that shit, dude, that game would be insane. It's just such a good game, and it's so underappreciated. It's gotten more light on it because of Heroes, but it's still so many people need to play that game.
I was going to say, they can finally give those Fire Emblem Heroes characters their own game to, like, or it would be really nice to know, like, what their deal is.
You goddamn meme lord. Oh, jeez. Yeah, no, I some sort of a Fire Emblem remake, I'm expecting. It's got to be either Genealogy of the Holy War or some sort of, like, Path of Radiance, Radiant Dawn bundle remake, which would be insane and really cool. But
yeah, if someone else, if Intelligent Systems is too busy and, like, someone else just touched up the graphics or something on Atelius games and just ported that would be amazing.
That would be good, too, yeah, honestly. That'd be cool. Yeah, that'd be acceptable. And, I mean, it's hard, because, like,
to anticipate now, but that'd be cool.
Yeah, yeah. It's hard, because, like, I know there's a lot of people that like to have the digital media, and there's emulation as well, of course, but, or not the digital, but the physical media. But, like, the physical media of Path of Radiance and Radiant Dawn is so expensive. Like, it's so hard to get a hold of.
Last time I saw it at a store, it was $242.
Dude, and, yeah.
It's not the way I played it.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I can't blame you, dude. Like, I lucked out and got physical copies of both back when they were relevant. And, like, you could still get them at GameStop used. But, like, there's so many people who can't, and that was back before Fire Emblem was popular, so it was easy to get. Now, forget it.
A fan.
So, you know, yeah.
You were being a loyal fan, and you bought it when it came out. You deserve play.
Yeah, no, you're right.
Yeah. Grayson's saying Three Houses 2.
You know, listen. Six houses. Nine houses. Yeah. It's Three Houses squared.
My chow have lineages, backstories, families in the works. Wow.
Whew! That's dedication, Shimia. Really, do you need to pick up a Switch, Star? I mean, listen, if there's something on it that you would like to play, then yeah, absolutely. Speaking of which, what do you think about the rumblings of a Switch Pro reveal today, Ben?
I don't know. I'm a non-believer. I don't think it'll happen.
You don't think so?
Because, people rumor it every year.
Mm.
This year there's been a ton of rumors, but I still don't believe it, because
fair.
I just heard it too much.
That's fair.
It would be really nice. I would like it. I would probably buy one, but I don't think they will.
Yeah, I guess I'd never heard about it before this point, like, so that's why it's just now on my radar. And, like, it would be
hearing about it, like, before the Switch came out, people were like, I'll wait till they make the Switch Pro.
Oh, oh yeah, like, I mean... Nintendo does have a track record of that, to be fair. They do have a track record of, like, here's the 3DS, here's the better 3DS, here's the DS, here's the better DS. So...
Here's the worst DS.
Yeah. Yeah.
Heroes 3, Fire Emblem 3 Houses, Breath of the Wild 1 and 2, etc. Oh, those are all the things...
That you would want. Yeah. That, no, I mean, that's a good roster. Nintendo Dolphin System win.
Switch feels too young for a pro. I mean, when did it come out? 2017? It's been like over 4 years now.
The Xbox and PS4 got pro versions around that timeline.
Yeah, about GameCube only lasted like, what, 5 years?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah. That was back when consoles like were advancing so quickly, though, they had to get, like... 3D was just becoming more and more detailed.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, they needed to meet that bar.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, so, I mean, as far as, like, Nintendo E3 things for me, I definitely Fire Emblem. I want just a release date of Triangle Strategy. I don't even need to see anything new. I just want to know when it's coming out, just for the sake of planning with the channel. Honestly.
A Triangle Strategy trailer... the release date at the end, and then one more announcement, we're replacing that one voice actor.
Oh no! I mean, they must have gotten a lot of feedback about him.
Probably.
Oh god, I feel bad for the poor guy, but it's like, if all of the VA was bad, it'd be like, okay, it's just the VA is just bad. But like, most of the other voices were passable to good. So it was like, it just stood out so much.
Oh man, we're like 10 minutes away.
I know, I'm excited.
Okay, final Smash Bros. Predictions, because they gotta have some, right?
Oh, for sure, 100%. 2B.
Ah, 2B.
I'm just throwing that one out there. We've got a 2B bean in Fall Guys, anything's possible.
Right.
Star wants to see Silk Song. Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
I think they outright said that there's not going to be anything at E3 this year, but...
Oh, they're working hard on it.
Oh, hello, for sure.
Epic Tom. Hello, IR Fine.
Oh, yes. Hello, everyone. Thanks for rolling up. You guys ready? You guys going to be excited for some big Nintendo E3 nonsense?
My Smash Bros. Like newcomer wet dream. Besides Ridley, I always just wanted Ridley. After that, everything's icing on the cake, but...
Fair.
I would love Chosen Undead from Dark Souls so much.
Oh, that would be cool.
And Dark Souls is on the Switch, like, they have the excuse.
They do, and, like, that would give
them
such...
It's my favorite game. It's done so much for just games over the past 10 years.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, dude. As I always say, like, Dark Souls did for action RPGs as Halo did for the shooter genre. Like, it's hugely influential.
Speaking of, Sir Phoenix says Master Chief in Smash.
That would be fun. That'd be fun.
I love that. I get to recreate Haloid.
Oh, God, you're right. Jeez. But no, going back to the Chosen Undead thing for a second, that would be really cool because, like, we know that they like fighters that have a really big versatility of what they can do canonically, so that they have a lot that they can do in Smash. And, I mean... Chosen Undead has...
Pyromancies, all the different weapon types.
Yeah, every single different type of spell, every single different type of weapon. And you could make just all of the iconic armor sets as different skins for them. Like, it would be huge. It would be really, really cool. I could actually see them wanting to do that.
I've seen people make up, like a bunch of move sets and stuff for him, and they all seem like such fun ideas.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can imagine. It would kind of be, it would almost be like playing as the Soul of Cinders, right? From the end of DS3?
Yeah, pretty much. Like, that's kind of what I was imagining.
Yeah, that would be sick.
Every kind of type of magic or pyromancy that you can think of.
It has moves that you literally only could get in Dark Souls 1. Like, you don't even have access to them in Dark Souls 3. Like, the one, like, ring flip dodge that you can do and everything. I don't remember. Exactly. I don't remember the name of that ring.
The Darkwood Grain Ring.
Yes.
Yeah.
Master Chief. Yep. Hello, Coda. How you doing? Community's
welcome.
A bunch of suckers. Give us 2B. Yeah. Seriously, man. The Monster Hunter for Smash.
That'd be interesting. That's Rathalos in there.
Do they really?
It could be... Yeah, he's like a boss in story mode, so they licensed Rathalos, but they don't have, like, a character.
Huh.
It could be, like, Monster Hunter Rise, because that just came out.
True.
You know?
True, true. Minecraft and Smash, yeah.
Rip Monteom, yep.
Yeah. Smash Bros. Is also missing a solo grass Pokemon. They have Greninja and Incineroar, but no grass one. I thought... Wasn't that a thing that you could play as the individual, like, Pokemon trainer Pokemon now, or am I misremembering?
Yeah, you could just pick Ivysaur, I guess, if you wanted to, but...
Hmm. What would you think, like...
It's not its own slot, unfortunately.
Yeah. Looking at...
If it was a Pokemon, I'd be kind of disappointed, but I could see it happening.
Yeah. Well, especially because there's probably going to be... Actually...
Sword and Shield.
There's going to
be a Sword and Shield Pokemon.
They don't. Then there's going to be footage, probably, from the Diamond and Pearl remakes, right? So they might bundle in some Pokemon stuff with that.
I don't know if they'll show off anything Pokemon, just because Pokemon has its own series of directs now.
True. True.
I think they like having just that spotlight on it.
That's fair. If they were going to have a solo grass Pokemon to put in Smash, like, alongside, Greninja and Incineroar, who do you think it would be? What would be a good pick? Rillaboom?
Who's... Was that the new one? The monkey dude?
The monkey drummer man, yeah.
I have a friend who's, like, been begging for years for them to add Sceptile. For
Ooh.
Ruby
and Sceptile. That would actually
be pretty... That's the first thing that just comes to mind.
That could be pretty cool, too.
He'd be a cool fighter.
Yeah, I would like that. I would like something a little heavier, though. Like, I would love to get Torterra or something ridiculous like that. That'd be sick.
Cool. Torterra.
Woodhammer. Just bop! Between Pokemon and FE, they take up 30% of the cast. Yeah, that's true.
We're, like, 5 minutes away. Less than. Do you want to switch over to the Nintendo? The big red screen of death?
Potentially. Let me see here. What do they have going on?
It's live, but it could be any second now.
Yeah, I have the I have it up, and then I will as soon as they actually switch over to not just the window of hey, this is what's happening, I'll pull it up lest I dox myself.
Okay, gotcha.
The owl starter with the bow. Oh, dude, yeah, Decidueye would be really cool. That would be awesome.
Oh, that would actually probably be the most likely pick, wouldn't it?
Yeah, because then they could have a ranged moveset and everything. That would be cool.
Four-legged fighters are great. Torterra would be amazing. Superior. A snake fighter.
That would be interesting, too, yeah. Four-legged fighters are great. Next Smash character will be from something coming out this year to help sell the product. Also possible. Also possible.
What's coming out this year?
That's a great question.
Mario Golf, okay.
Yeah, right?
Luigi. It's real.
Only really played Gen 1 and 5, so my exposure is limited. Those are two solid gens, though. Not bad.
God,
Gen
5 is so good. So good. I want to play it again.
Yeah, I know. That's
Gen 3 is my personal favorite, but Gen 5 is like, oh.
Last little thing I'll throw in before this is about to pop off. Have you seen the multiplayer like versus mods that people have been doing for the Pokemon games, Ben?
No, I don't know. Like ROM hacks?
Yeah.
No, I don't think I have. That sounds cool, though.
Yeah, I think my buddy was telling me about it. It's like in Red and Blue, like one person plays like the normal player character, the trainer, and one person controls like all of the other trainers, and you just play against each other through the story.
That sounds awesome, actually. I would love to do that.
Yeah, I thought that was super cool. I was like, oh, man, I have to look into how this works at some point, but I've just been so busy.
I've only played Fire Red, Sun, and White as far as Pokemon goes.
Not a bad collection. Not a bad collection.
I've played through all the Pokemon games, and I have big opinions on where they've taken it recently, but...
Oh, we know.
You were there for when I streamed Sword and Shield. It was just... losing my mind at the final hours of that game.
God, man. I enjoyed way more of Sword and Shield than you did. I am more than happy to admit its flaws. However, those last few hours were just absolute dog shit. I'm sorry. That was bad.
Nice Skywalker of video games.
Oh, God. It was...
Keep going through the story. Don't ask questions.
Don't think about
the details. It's happening.
Just get to the end game so you can go enjoy what there is of that. All right, I'm going to kill the near soundtrack because we are just about here. Oh, all right, it's live. Here we go.
Oh, my God.
Taking this down. We're here, team. SEAL Team 6, let's go! Oh, I'm excited. Ugh.
Sub 1 minute left.
I know. The fact that it's actually a video now, I just got unreasonably hyped. Is Volcarona
start with that Smash Cross thing, and then you're gonna be like, "Oh, who's it gonna be?"
Probably, yeah.
Is Volcarona a Pokemon summon yet? Oh, in Smash,
yeah, I feel like it should be. That's a pretty good one.
I really like that Pokemon. I named mine Solaire from the Dark Souls series.
Oh, that's a very good choice.
Do I turn my volume up or down? Both, like, alternate, like, really fast.
Just vacillate violently between mute and unmute. Come on, guys. Give it to us. Who knows? Yeah, right?
Oh, my gosh. I shouldn't be getting my hopes up, but my heart's, like...
I know. Plus, I'm drinking my coffee right now, so I'm, like, getting an extra boost of acceleration.
Followed by 3 hours of Treehouse. Right. Are we going to watch some of that? Or?
You know what? I figured we could decide on that once we actually see the direct and see what they're going to be showing. So,
The one that they had 4 years ago.
Oh, here we go. Focus up.
I was going to say, they announced new games during the Treehouse thing once. So now I'm like...
True.
What if they had...
Oh boy, that's loud.
Yeah, it's loud.
We're going to just bring that down for you guys real quick, maybe.
It's fine.
Hello, everyone.
Let's go!
I'm Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world...
5 years.
Nintendo Switch is being enjoyed by a wide range of players spanning all ages and all levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much.
Please save E3, please.
We've been able to offer a wide variety.
Listen, Microsoft did really well for themselves, let's be honest.
Oh, Shamia says up a tiny bit. Also, maybe put on closed captions.
Okay.
I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal
tastes. There we go.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games.
How's that for you guys now?
Focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it. Okay, to begin, please take a look at this video.
Oh, what's it gonna be?
Come on, maybe it starts with something big. Is it Smash?
Is that Smash? Or...
That's Ganon.
The Zelda thing?
That's Ganon being carried by Ryu?
Oh, it's Tekken. Tekken's in Smash.
Oh! you know what? You're right!
Oh my god, okay.
No shit! Alright, cool.
Didn't see that one coming, but cool.
Yeah! I like them just hucking Ganon into the pits of Mordor.
Yeah, that's like that famous scene in Tekken where I think he drops his father into the lava.
Oh, see, I don't know anything about Tekken, so that went over my head.
I admittedly don't know a lot, but I know at least that.
We can probably bring this up a little bit more for you guys. No, not Captain Falcon!
No!
Oh no, Pit!
Oh no!
Oh god, everybody! Oh! No, Marth! Jesus Christ!
Oh, now he's Devil Kazuya. Samus, no! I think I'm Devil Man. These Smash trailers are always so fun.
Oh yeah. Yeah, they have a lot of fun with these.
Oh, okay, they got the rest of the cast in the back, like the SNK one.
Nice. Kazuya Mishima wins. Alright.
What a way to open it.
Yeah, that's pretty... Oh, no, not Kirby!
No! No!
Get him, Kirby, get him, get him, get him!
Come on, just fly back up. You have infinite jumps.
Hey, there he is! How are sound levels for you guys now that I bumped it up a bit again?
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited and the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game. Kazuya Mishima from the fighting game series Tekken will join the battle.
Surprise! That's really good. That was
I'll
good.
Go over the details at a later date, so please sit tight. For today, though, we've prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please take a look.
Oh, every Smash trailer is the main cast getting bodied? Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, really. They made a habit of that.
Alright, I'm gonna refill my water while we're looking at this real quick. I'll be right back.
Okay. I don't really know the Tekken moves or have played it. So. I mean, it does make sense, though, because, Bandai Namco, helped work on Smash, so...
Oh, yeah,
I remember seeing a lot of people predict this.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. That makes sense.
I mean, we got one fighter left for the fighter pass. So.
Oh, really? I haven't been following at all, so... We started screaming, my ears died. Sorry, Fine, I told you rip ears at the start of this! Oh no!
Oh, sorry.
Rip.
Kirby was dying, okay?
No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
See, no one cared if Ganondorf died at the beginning, but...
Yeah, oh yeah. That was just suitably dramatic.
We still have to record the
first, actually. Just kicks the arm off.
Yeah, that was good.
The air date is shown below. Please stay tuned.
Okay, what is that, like a week from now?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai.
All right, cool. Strong opener.
New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super
Will Nintendo
Smash
beat
Brothers
Microsoft
Ultimate?
Tonight? Let's find out.
Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game. All right, let's continue with our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
There's gonna be a lot of people like being like, I don't care about this weird fighting game thing.
Right. Tales. Ooh, what is this?
I'm not sure. Pretty.
Oh yeah, look at this.
Life is Strange, but animated?
It is. Huh. I'm suddenly way less interested, but it looks cool.
Oh, that's the new character.
Yeah. Do they just have, like, a Switch-specific version? No, it's just the animated trailer for it. Oh, fair enough.
Oh, okay, gotcha. They're putting both on Switch.
Oh, okay, yeah, there's the normal gameplay. Gotcha.
There it is.
Can the Switch handle that?
It's not the most graphically intense, like, with the characters, but the environment that's like that's what you're seeing now. They look very pretty.
Huh. Fair enough.
Life is Strange True Colors launches on Nintendo
Switch
September 10th.
Are they just skipping
10th.
The second
and
Life is
Strange Remastered Collection?
Well, because the Remastered Switch Collection, I think, year. Is maybe part of that. Maybe?
Maybe.
There's something for everyone on the Nintendo
Life
Switch
Strange
system.
2 was like about two brothers, and they weren't in the trailer at all, so I'm like...
Oh, fair enough. Lord. Oh, there's Guardians of the Galaxy. Listen,
on Switch?
Apparently. Jump on a wild ride and listen, I'm skeptical, but I was actually way more impressed with this trailer than I expected I would be. Like... It's gonna be
a good job. The art design looks incredible.
Yeah, yeah, it looks really fun. Like, I'm sure it's gonna be buggy as all hell. It'll be something to play like 3 years after it comes out, but it seems like it could actually be kind of cool.
In this real-time arena-based oh god!
Oh no shit!
Wait, no, this.
Oh, this is the Battle Royale one.
Yeah, okay, I bought this on Steam, and there weren't enough players to populate a single game, and I had to refund it.
Oh.
This is the worms I'm thinking of, the new Battle Royale one.
Oh. Oh,
it was like
no.
The most dead, and it was during a sale too.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Hopefully, it'll do better on Switch. Ooh.
Oh, right. This
fully hand-painted world, You'll customize a team of demigods.
This is cool looking. Rip frame rate though.
Yeah.
Astria Ascending launches on Nintendo Switch September 30th.
Astria Ascending, huh? Okay. I have to make a note of that.
I'm just going from trailer after trailer.
Return to the funny, charming, and quirky world of Two Point County.
None of them new games.
In the wholesome
yet,
management sim Two Point Campus.
That, yeah, they're probably loading the back end with the new stuff.
Lots of creative tools are at your disposal to make the school yours and take
Yeah, definitely going to have to check out Astria Ascending. That looks cool.
Enrollment for Two Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year.
Mm-hmm.
A beloved series rolls into its 20th anniversary this year.
Donkey Kong?
That's what it looked like. Oh!
No, it's Monkey Ball!
No kidding. Huh! This is another one I never played.
Oh god. I remember the first time I played a GameCube, it was like this game.
Was this a GameCube exclusive? Or was it like on earlier systems too?
I don't remember. I think it's on a bunch of stuff. It's
gotcha.
But
oh, okay.
It's a cool game. It's also hard. Like,
mm-hmm.
Very easy to knock the monkey to his death. That's cool though, it's getting a remaster.
That's
cool,
yeah, though. That's nice. I remember this being one that people like I've been seeing reminiscing about on Twitter and stuff recently, being like, oh, we're never gonna get another one, but
Super Monkey Ball, Banana Mania, rolls.
The speedruns of this game are insane. They're just...
Oh god, I can imagine.
It's a blast from parties past.
Uh-oh.
And you're invited. Ready for another
round new Mario Party,
Party mayhem? Of course you are. It's a superstar collection of Mario Party boards and minigames.
Huh.
Live it up on five classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era.
I... And they're just adding them to the current game, maybe?
It's the Mario 64 maps.
Oh, okay. We mean it.
And I think the minigame, like some of the minigames too. Yeah! Oh my god!
See, I, again,
oh, the clock one, I,
I again never played Mario Party, so as much as I want to.
I'm sorry, it's just, like, I played so much of Mario Party, especially 3.
Nah, you're fine, dude. I love this stuff. I love Mario Party. Just, like, I want to play it. I just have never had the chance.
Those old maps are better than, like, the current Mario Party maps. That's awesome.
I believe it.
Then resume the festivities. Stickers are also available to communicate with others.
Friendship Destroyer. Yes.
In Mario Party Superstars.
Oh,
great. Now, is that its own release, though? October
29th. I guess?
Huh.
Odd. Gray saying, dude, Super Monkey Ball 2 is harder than Souls.
Currently, yeah. We're
working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series.
You play with Jane Bell. Wait.
But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
Oh shit!
Please take a look.
Oh boy.
Bro.
What?
Oh my god!
What?
Okay, I'm drawing this later. Watch, it looks so good!
That looks so sick!
Metroid 5, it's fucking real!
Holy shit! Dude!
Fucking thank you, Nintendo! E3 saved! Look at this! Oh my god!
Is it gonna be like actual Metroid style? Like side? Yeah, it is! Look at this!
Yes!
Bro, this looks sick! Holy shit!
Bring it back to horror aspects too!
Oh god!
And the action stuff from Samus Return- Oh my god, it's real! Metroid Dread is real!
This looks legit as fuck, dude. Whoa.
Yo, that punch!
My hands are on my head. I can't believe it. Is this Mercury's team? Like the guys who made Samus Returns, the remake?
I have no idea.
It looks sort of like it. Oh my god, I can't.
This is so cool. Oh, whoa, 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 stealth?
Yo, oh, yes, the wall climbs back!
Dude, the internet's blowing up right now, I promise. This is insane.
Dread, dread. It's real. I can't.
Wow.
Need it, dude!
Dude.
All I needed. All I needed from this direct.
Dude, October!
Oh, it's October?
Whoa! Whoa!
Bringing that for sure.
That was the trailer for the first new Metroid game.
Sorry, I'm getting so loud, guys.
In 19 years!
Dread game. Mm-hmm.
As the name Dread implies, this is a Metroid game with a new feel, showcasing a variety of threats that Samus will encounter.
God damn,
it's scheduled
dude.
To be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long until launch. On that same day, we'll also be releasing
figures
for Samus and the Emmy.
The Emmy.
The robot seen in the video. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Cool stuff. Oh my god.
Wow,
you
man.
Just drop that in the middle of the
Get ready. All right, well, I don't give a shit about Just Dance. I'm going to grab my food, which has got here.
I'm just looking at Twitter. Everyone's freaking out. You guys in chat are freaking out. Oh, this every time they announce a Metroid thing, it's like obviously a huge deal because fans have been waiting so long. But the fact that it's Dread, the one that's been rumored for like what 15 years?
I guess I've never really heard of it before. So
it was a thing. It was a rumor project back around like fucking. Prime 2 or Prime 3, like they, people were saying like Metroid Dread is going to be a Nintendo DS Metroid, like a 2D one, and then Prime 3 had that little thing in one of the scan logs where it said Project Dread is underway, and people are like, oh, are they making Metroid Dread? But it's actually happened. I can't believe it.
Goddamn.
Other Z fighters through four sagas in this action RPG. What are these? Are these tears in my eyes? Come on.
This is something Jane's gonna enjoy. This looks cool.
The
evil
emperor. The Dragon Ball?
Yeah, she loves Dragon Ball. Battle the androids in
a fight to the death. Which one is this? Is this Xenoverse?
No, this is like a new, like, it's an action it's an action RPG.
Along with the main story, you can explore the vast world of Dragon Ball Z. Hey, why not help out the locals? Or collect ingredients for delicious meals? You could always train to acquire new skills, too. There are lots of things to keep you busy. I'm so blown away.
I mean, I can't blame you, dude. Holy shit. That was like, that was your big thing right there.
Well, I was saying Prime 4 this whole time, but like, this is just as good.
Oh, well, yeah.
This will hold me over for sure.
And they also fully acknowledged Prime 4, which is great, too.
The Mario Golf Super Rush game launches soon.
Oh boy,
unlike Zelda, where it's like, sorry, we don't have the new Zelda. Here's like a port or whatever. Who cares? Here's a new Metroid game.
It's like, that absolute insanity.
Metroid 4, aka Fusion, was what, 2001, 2002? So it's been a minute. It's like they could have kept remaking other Metroid games, but no, a new one.
Well, that's what I was saying. Like,
so excited.
That's what they were like, the first new Metroid game in 19 years. I was like, holy shit.
It's been so long.
Gray says, does Dread make up for no Prime 4 info?
Absolutely, absolutely, without a doubt. Golf adventure. Go from rookie to pro with your Mii character. Nothing can top Metroid Dread, Extreme Time Falter. Metroid Dread is one of those, like, vaporware legends. Like, with, I'm talking over Mario Golf or whatever.
I mean,
the fairway's almost open.
So set your tee time and get ready to ace those shots.
What's another example? Super Rush. I can't even think of one.
The Nintendo Switch system, June 25th.
Pre-order. I know what you're talking about, Nintendo though. Nintendo eShop.
Mm-hmm. Like, we're talking Half-Life 3 levels of anticipation. In fact, mm-hmm. it's been longer than the wait for Half-Life 3.
Welcome mm-hmm. to the vast and vibrant world of Monster Just... Hunter.
Nope, here's
Nintendo Stadium 3. They did it. As if I had any doubt, which I kind of did.
I mean, listen, man, Nintendo has let us down in the past. A
monster companion. But, I mean, wilder things have happened. It's not often that Microsoft has the best show up to this point, and they did, so, like, you know.
Yeah. Microsoft, I love how they have adapted just trailer after trailer mm-hmm. for their shows. They've really cooled down since that one E3.
I was going to say,
they were talking about TV the whole time.
Yeah, we ripped the shit out of them when there was like an hour and a half of, here's everything but games.
And you'll be rewarded with their materials, which can be forged into new weapons and armor.
Yeah, Metroid Dread was just rumors for years and years.
And then the fact that like there's a actual like new game coming out this year, the same time that they announce it, like Jesus.
Can't wait.
Buckle up, right? I'm gonna play it. Absolutely, I'm gonna play it.
Yes. Well, you gotta play Metroid 1, 2, 3, and 4 first.
Oh my God! Listen, man. July 9th.
You can play the free demo on June 25th and carry okay. over your okay, save. we got focus back on the direct. Mario Golf and Monster Hunter Stories 2 are already announced.
Yep.
Here's a new game. Oh, hey!
Wario?
WarioWare! Whoa, that looks very detailed for... Wait, is that, like, real life?
What do you mean? Who am I?
My God.
Wario.
Oh my God, I love this already.
Finally ready. A brand new game.
Oh, that's cool. It's just, like... Is the whole thing 2D over just real life?
It to do this. Maybe. Look at me. Ah, oh, God, I love WarioWare though. Rats.
Check out these chumps. They came back and they have wonderful new talents.
I love Wario's voice as well. This is great.
Not the bad.
It's awesome. Whatchamacallit. Nailed it. It's cool seeing these characters, like, they have the 2D style, but they look like they're 3D now.
Yeah, they are definitely 3D, which is interesting.
I'm terrible at these games, but they are fun. Okay, Coda.
When does Waluigi get a game? Ah, that's a good question, isn't it?
Someday. Someday he'll get his.
Tweez! Oh, God. About time, says Captain Foxtrot. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this shit is... Oh. WarioWare Get It Together game launches exclusively. I wonder if there'd be a multiplayer version of this. That'd be fun.
Pre-orders begin today. I think so. Like, I think the last couple have had, like, some multiplayer stuff.
Did they? Cool.
Or, like, at least a mode where it's like, hey, pass the controller around, haha.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare Get It Together. In the latest installment of this series, there are new microgames that let
Ashley
you
hype. Yeah.
Mario and his friends. There is also a two-player co-op.
Oh, there is. Nice.
Greatly expands the game.
There you go. Perfect.
It's releasing in the near future, so stay tuned.
That's something I can see myself doing a little mini-series of with Jane.
That would be fun.
That would be a lot of fun. Oh, this.
SMT5.
Yeah, I was gonna say this is some SMT right here. Student living in Tokyo. Your life
is fairly normal. I was pretty sure they were going to do a new trailer, so...
Was this previously announced?
This? Yeah.
Okay.
They've had a couple trailers, but... Into a different dimension. Yeah. This needs all the, marketing it can get, so...
Yeah.
I'm glad they're getting it off now.
I'm still unclear of the connection between SMT and Persona, because they are connected, aren't they? In some way?
Yeah, Persona is like a spin-off of SMT.
Okay.
It uses all the same demons from SMT that like you fight reside. And talk to.
Okay, got it.
In Persona, you like kind of summon them like Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. You fuse with a mysterious figure, gaining the power to fight demons. Whereas in this, you are the demon, I guess. In this alternate realm.
I think you fight them like directly, or you fight with them. Oh wait, is that female main character?
It was very unclear. Might be intentionally androgynous, hard to say.
It might be. And will attempt to destroy
you.
Because they looked like they were wearing a male uniform, using a command-based system.
Finding their weak point is key. Wow, that battle HUD looks great.
Yeah, that looks really cool.
The number of consecutive actions you can perform in a combo will increase.
Well, you were asking about the gameplay. Here it is.
Yeah.
Formidable opponents.
I don't need to half guess anymore.
This is
played SMT, just Persona.
This is really slick looking. Off to a good start. SMT has already had demi fiends. Gotcha.
If a negotiation is successful, a demon.
Guys, are you enjoying this so far? Because like, holy shit, this has been a hell of a direct. And we're only 24 minutes in. Cases,
by rejecting a demon's request, they may feel motivated and join you as an ally.
Motivated? Don't make cry in again. Join, we'll fight alongside you and grow stronger. This Dante walks on screen.
By oh my god!
Allies, what the hell is this? Created. It's Beelzebub.
The newly fused demon's innate abilities.
You can fuse them.
Granting you a powerful ally, customized to your needs and playstyle.
Yeah, that was always a thing in SMT. Also, Persona had it too. Go look at SMT4 and see how much of an upgrade this is, really. What destiny, like, from a 3DS to this.
Oh god, it was on the 3DS? Holy smokes.
Yeah, that was the last one. 4 was on the 3DS. November 12th!
God damn! They weren't kidding that this is all stuff coming out this year. Holy.
Yeah, they're stacked up 2023. We got to dread.
Shin Megami Tensei 5 from Atlas.
Wow.
This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates.
Not a big Nintendo fan, but it's all right. Hey, you know.
SMT 5 was like announced almost at the beginning of the Switch's life cycle. So
really?
It's been a long time coming.
Ah, Danganronpa.
Danganronpa. Is that actually the same voice actor as Teddy from Persona, or am I just like hearing things?
Very good question. I would not know.
It sounded very similar, unless that's just what they were going for.
Which, possible, possible.
Monokuma, the self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other high school students in a game of literal life and death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. And so it begins.
A body has been discovered!
When a student meets their demise, a class trial will take place to reveal the culprit.
You're the culprit, aren't you, Mew?
Tanya, I had no idea!
They probably moved the body there!
Use the evidence you've gathered to refute contradictions and find the guilty party.
Sneak attack!
I could never get over Danganronpa's arc. Wow. The character designs, like, normally I'm like, yeah, anime, but this one bugs me in particular.
it's so out there and bizarre and unique.
Yeah.
Into a standalone game. Danganronpa S,
Is this like a new thing? I don't know if enough about Danganronpa, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Who's the strongest of them all in this ultimate beach brawl? The four-game collection Danganronpa Decadence launches.
I am unclear on this, but I'm sure Danganronpa fans are very excited.
All four games will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop.
Oh, interesting.
Wow. Okay.
Ooh. New Fatal Frame?
Afraid of ghosts.
It's a new one? Maiden of Blackwater. Is that an old one?
I think it is. I think it is an older one. I think it's the last one that came out.
You'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami, believed to be at the center.
Another game stolen from the Wii U.
Ghosts frequent this mountain.
Was it really on the Wii U?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Face your fears as you explore a variety of unsettling locations.
Nintendo's killing it, though.
Oh yeah, they are. Absolutely, dude.
Letting you experience the game from different perspectives. New costumes and photo mode.
I'm just blown away right now.
Can you investigate Mount Hikami? And stay.
So I guess I know what I'm doing immediately after the stream. just drawing Samus in her new outfit.
Yep.
These games. Oh, the cover art looks sick. I'm sorry, I'm on Twitter right now. Just
Oh, Doom. There you go.
War is not over. Raise hell in the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, the Ancient Gods Part 1.
I cannot believe that Doom is on the Switch. It's just so wild.
Yeah, it's kind of black magic, maybe Archon energy that they use to make it run on the Switch.
The fate of the cosmos.
Absolutely
is in your
insane.
Hands. Get slaying when this campaign expansion.
Like, obviously, it doesn't look anywhere near as good as it does elsewhere, but it's still just impressive from an idea standpoint.
That, oh yeah, it's Tony Hawk.
Oh yeah.
HD. Nice.
Skate to era-defining jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new and returning.
God, Samus's new design looks so good. I'm sorry, it's just like they have the fusion colors, but like the suit sort of looks like it, but it also sort of looks like her old suit. It's like the perfect balance of.
Pro Skater 1 and 2. No, I like it. I've never seen a suit of hers that I like more than like her OG orange one, but I like that one a lot.
Really good.
After 4,000 years, Sateki, the Witch Queen, has risen from the dead, and only one group of heroes can stop her. The Strange Brigade.
Okay.
In this thrilling adventure, you'll.
This is very indie, or very third party.
Solving puzzles in booby-trapped
yeah.
dungeons. Go it alone or team up with other daring.
Something tells me this is a port from somewhere else.
And possibly, play. Yeah.
Maybe.
Expect the unexpected. It's definitely a four-player co-op game, though.
Nintendo Switch later today.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, it's okay. It's out today.
Oh wow.
Very well. It's a new. Hey, yep. There's Mario and Rabbids.
Hey.
I guess I need to play this at some point.
Yeah, it's like an XCOM thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right up the alley.
Mysterious new evil from plunging the universe into chaos.
Grace, this has so many fond memories of Tony Hawk. It's
Rabbit
here, man.
Rosalina joins them. Wait,
yeah, I was never in on Tony Hawk, but I know so many people really enjoyed it.
Residents and even quirkier secrets.
It's fun. It's a really fun skating game. I love Rabid Rosalina in this, how lazy she is.
Yeah.
That animation in the trailer of her getting out of the chair is the best. Like, ugh.
Wait, who's that? Well, one thing's certain. This is gonna be one heck of a galactic adventure.
I never expected this game to take off, let alone get a sequel, but you know what? I dig it.
Yeah, me neither. Next year. Good for them. Oh.
Wait!
What?
What? No!
Oh, I'm getting this.
No way! Holy shit!
Oh, it's alive!
Oh my god!
It's alive!
This is like the Let's fucking go! God, I hope I muffled my screams enough. Jesus Christ. No way! Dude!
Oh my god, yes!
It looks so good!
It looks great. It just... player in
store, as you like, the commanding officers... this is like the closest I could expect to... Well, it's not Fire Emblem, but it may as well be Fire Emblem. It's both of them?! No way, dude!
December 3rd!
What the hell?
How is everything?
I got mine, you got yours.
All right. This next segment will be our last announcement.
Oh boy, last one.
Please.
I'm already good. Thank you, Nintendo.
What is this going to be? It's got to be Zelda, right? It is. Oh no.
Hyrule Warriors?
Oh, Hyrule Warriors. No, there's no way this is the last announcement of the day then. No way.
I guess it is. But Link gets a bicycle? You get to play is the big thing?
I mean, that's pretty legit if you do. Alright, that's a cool weapon, but...
Oh. That is cool. I don't really have much interest in this game after playing the first Zelda, Hyrule Warriors.
Yeah.
Hell no, there needs to be something else. Yeah, I'm kind of like, really, DLC?
Yeah, no, there's definitely something else. That's way too insane of a... There's 6 minutes left.
There he is.
Oh, boy. Here it is.
Producer of The Legend of Zelda
Skyward Sword. No.
What you've just seen is a trailer for the first wave of DLC for the Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity expansion pass from Koei Tecmo Games. It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I hope you
still don't get why Aonuma specifically gets to be kept in the Black Void while everyone else can run around free.
That's a good question, isn't it?
Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month.
Okay, right. This is like a whole Zelda segment, not just Hyrule Warriors. Two Joy-Con
controllers, which makes me think, if it's at the end of a Direct, wouldn't there be something of Breath of the Wild 2?
I think they're building up to it.
It kind of feels like it, doesn't it?
It's the oldest era in the Legend of Zelda series, the story of how it all began.
I'm reeling from Advance Wars. What I thought it was dead as a doornail. My god.
Why? And it's both. I am 100% buying that because, like, I always wanted to play Advance Wars once I was done with Fire Emblem. In this game.
It's, but dude.
I'll have more Fire Emblem to play, too.
We hope you're looking forward to the Legend
of God, I cannot believe. Sword HD. You did miss Advance Wars, Charlie.
Next up.
Oh, boy. Oh?
What the?
Here's a little something you might like.
This is
a Game & Watch system that lets you play Zelda New Dad in the Legend of Zelda series.
Huh.
This year, the original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary.
Zelda 1, Zelda 2, and Link's Awakening?
Probably.
Nintendo Switch games planned. We've been working on this Game & Watch system as a special item to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of the Legend of Zelda.
That's really cute. I like that.
I thought they gave up on it for Fire Emblem, but I love Advance Wars. This could be it. This could be them testing, like, can Advance Wars sell? Can we make a revival or a sequel?
And
or
the Game Boy version of the Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening game, as well as a special version of the Game & Watch title Vermin, starring Link as a playable character.
That's cute.
So that's four games on one system, from longer Legend of Zelda
There's Link's Awakening.
To the pick-up-and-play game Vermin. In addition, regarding the watch functionality for the Game & Watch system, we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda.
That's funny.
We can play it. And an it was just a clock.
Named after Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link. You can play with both of them by taking...
I never knew that that's why it was called the Game & Watch. Huh.
We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system whenever and wherever you like.
I actually didn't put that together until now either.
Yeah. I had no idea.
All right.
Oh boy.
Here's the last thing we have to show you.
Here it is.
This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Here it is!
I knew it!
Years have passed since we first announced this game, and we've been unable to share anything with you in that time. However,
yeah, Nintendo won E3, hands down.
For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the game. Please take a look.
Yeah, that's evil.
Mm-hmm. That's some Calamity Ganon-ness right there.
Tell the no!
Oh!
Oh!
Are we doing Skyward Sword?
Loading Islands?
Aha! Oh, that's cool.
Built on the stone, dude.
Ooh.
Yo, time stop.
Oh, you become water. You're a kid now. You're a squid now.
God. And the music is like some backwards creepy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Building castle.
He just yeets Hyrule Castle into the sky. See, I still don't know how the original Breath of the Wild ended, because Jane hasn't finished it yet, and I haven't played it, so...
Oh, well, let me tell you.
No. This is... Huh.
That's it? 2022? Wow, next year.
Alright, fair enough.
So, what did you think? This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule. We'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer. We're aiming for a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
Okay.
Reverse song Saria, maybe.
Hmm.
How was that? That's all for this Nintendo Direct. We are diligently
That was awesome. Yeah. Wow. Didn't
show today. Long appealing. Oh my god.
Continue looking forward to what's in store on Nintendo Switch. Thank you for watching.
Hmm.
Incredible.
All right. Well done, Nintendo. Well done. Well done. I am very impressed. I will admit I didn't get Fire Emblem or Triangle Strategy, but but I did get the absolute out of left field Advance Wars that I'm 100% down with. That was solid. That was solid.
Hi everyone, I'm Doug Bowser from Nintendo.
Sneaky Advance Wars punch.
And there's Bowser,
who leads our treehouse. Yeah, there he is. All this scaly goodness. Yeah, okay, going off what Star was saying, I was going to say, like, the last time we had a direct Zelda sequel was Majora's Mask, wasn't it?
I think so, yeah.
That one was so creative and dark, and it kind of seems like this is what the vibe of this one's going to be. I know that's asking for a lot, because Majora's Mask is amazing, but, like, man.
I mean, I'm always down for more Dark Zelda. Like, I haven't played a lot of them, but I loved what I played of Twilight Princess. I loved what I played of Majora's Mask. So if we could get more of that type of thing, I'd be all in on it.
Superstars, WarioWare, get it together. The expansion for Hyrule Warriors.
Oh, Age Metroid!
I cannot believe that, dude. Like, two things that neither of us were expecting at all. Absolutely insane. You should know
that. Well, that's okay. I thought, like, maybe Prime 4. Maybe if I was extremely lucky, Prime 4. But Metroid 5? Never.
We not, and not only announced it, but it's coming out in, like, a few months. Like,
we are. In case he gets a hole in one.
Oh my god.
But seriously, everyone.
God damn.
What are they doing? Are they going to play Mario Golf? Is that
standard golf mode? But then there's also.
Looks like it, yeah.
Battle Golf. The Golf Adventure mode.
Maybe my dad would like that. He loves golf games.
Right.
And you
can play with up to four people locally or online.
So, how are you guys feeling in chat? I know there was a bunch of reactions and stuff flying by, but I was too busy freaking out to catch everything. What about this Direct are you happiest about? Are you the most excited about?
Next up, we, of course, have Nintendo Treehouse Live, and we'll be kicking off our first segment with a very special guest, Yoshio Sakamoto, who is the producer of Metroid Dread.
Oh
yes.
Okay. All right. Yeah, we can check this out.
First 2D, new 2D Metroid game in nearly two decades.
Look, yes.
I know you've been looking forward.
That's so insane, dude.
So looking forward to this.
And we. I can't believe they called it Dread. Like,
that's so cool.
Into Metroid Dread, WarioWare, get it together, and more games in a mix of both live and pre-recorded segments today. And I just like to say, as we close,
like a WarioWare too.
Deeply grateful we are to everyone. That's super cool today. Thank you for sharing this time with us, and we hope you enjoy.
I wonder who's making Dread, though. Like, it looked like Mercury Steam.
And with that, I'll turn it over.
Who did the Samus Returns remake.
Mm-hmm.
So I bet that was the entire, like, point, where it's like, this is seeing if they could do a Metroid. Now you can do our new title.
Oh, okay, gotcha, yeah.
That was probably the plan or something. Oh my god, it looks so good! It looks so good!
It really does. Also, answer you guys in chat. Zelda 2, I think, is actually a prequel to Zelda 1. And then Link's Awakening is a sequel to A Link to the Past.
2D Metroid. Oh, yeah, because he goes off on the ship.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. There's Metroid 1. Pew, pew. There's 2. Super.
Metroid Fusion.
That's God, man! Wow! And it looks so good.
It's got the fusion kind of visor with the point in the center, and it's got the color scheme.
This looks extremely faithful.
シリーズではそのメトロイドと主人公サモスとの奇妙な関係性を綴ってきました。Oh yeah, Monkey Ball. That was a cool one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we're getting Chozo stuff? We get new lore.
God, see, I'm already completely lost as far as lore stuff goes. This just looks so cool.
Okay. Oh my God, that looks so good. That was the intro to Metroid Fusion, but like redone in HD. It looks gorgeous.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's like shot for shot the same. Oh my God. I love it. Love it.
All right, let me see what you guys are saying in chat. Jimmy's excited for Dread and Breath of the Wild 2. Grayson's talking about Dread. Everyone's talking about Dread.
Oh yeah, Link Between Worlds. That was also a direct sequel, right, Star?
Oh yeah. New Monkey Ball game probably won't be the best, but Gray's excited about it. Star can't really say because Dread wiped mind of most of the stream.
Yeah.
Monkey Ball and Advance Wars hit you right in the nostalgia. Yeah.
Oh man.
So they like stopped and restarted development a bunch of times.
Well, I guess all the rumors were real. Oh, hey. Mm-hmm. Exactly what I was saying. Mercury's team. It looks so much like Samus Returns. I was like, mm-hmm. This has got to be them. The way the camera was moving around.
Yeah. Yeah, you can see the direct gameplay style.
And they added the thing where Samus can do like parries, and it goes into like an action.
Yeah.
Like, shoots them or punches them, and I'm glad they're bringing that back because that was a really cool like feature.
Yeah, I like that a lot.
This thing.
Mm-hmm.
実は銀河連邦所有の調査ロボットなんです。
Yeah, I hate that it moves around kind of grudge-like. That freaks me out.
I'm really happy they're adding another pursuer enemy. Because Metroid Fusion had a really great one. It's like, you know, like Mr. X from Resident Evil 2, where they follow you around.
Right.
But in Fusion, because it was on the Game Boy Advance, it was all kind of like scripted sequences.
Mm-hmm.
This could be an actual pursuer that just goes through the levels and fucks with you.
That's what it looked like, yeah.
There's a post I retweeted right before this direct, and it was like, bring back a horror Metroid game. And we got it!
Phantom Cloak.
Phantom Cloak. Vision is based on movement.
Yeah, right! Two is a prequel.
Speedrunners are screaming right now. No, you're wasting frames by hiding. Oh, Mario Party. Mario Party was cool. I'm kind of like a little miffed that it's its own release and not DLC or something. But...
Yeah.
Unless it's like, A, it's $30, but it's Nintendo, so I kind of doubt it.
Yeah, it's going to be 60, guaranteed.
Oh, they brought back the little rings. Oh, she uppercutted that alien to death.
Yeah, what? That was sick.
She's got a slide?
Oh my God, this is so legit.
Instead of turning to Morph Ball, just slide.
And the music is so tense. I love the music being so tense.
So excited for this game, dude. Oh, look, it's a Chozo statue. Huh. 3D. Alright, dream.
Oh, you can, like, climb up into a vent and turn into a ball in one motion. That's nice.
They added that in Fusion. It's been, like, a really good quality of life thing. Because Super mm-hmm. didn't have that. You played Super.
Spider Magnet? Oh!
Yeah, it's a wall climb! There was, like, a grip thing that you could attach to your arm in Fusion that did this. I'm really happy it's back.
Wow.
So Emmy is a T-Rex?
Yeah. Yeah, honestly. Here, let me take the closed captioning off. It's really making this hard to read.
Yeah, it is. Thank you. Looks so good. It looks so good.
Okay, we're going to see more. We're going to see more right here.
I don't want to see too much of the game, but also I can't help myself.
Well, I mean, we can always dip whenever you want. I'm 100% down to watch it. I'm down to dip as well.
No, I'm just almost crying seeing this. Just a giant Metroid thing behind them. Like, look at this series. I'm super excited. We're back. About this next segment. Oh, look, there's like a bunch of like strands on her armor.
Yeah, like muscle fibers.
Where are the other parts?
New moves in action. And also, I think get to a little bit of the.
Shmia says, "I've seen enough. I'm satisfied. That's, Tom, Epic Tom, that's give fair. Me more."
Gets the game title. So I'm joined by Audrey and Teresa from Nintendo Treehouse, and Teresa's going to take us into the depths of Planet ZDR.
Yeah. Planet right. ZDR? DDR?
Deep dive.
I think I said ZDR.
ZDR.
So we're going to backtrack just a little bit to show Samus's free movement here. So like I just spent a little few missiles, so I'm gonna use this.
Oh, recharge.
Okay.
Nice.
But one of the things I want to show here is free aim, which for those that
oh, it's back.
That's nice.
Returns, this is mm-hmm. made a comeback.
Oh, it looks so smooth too.
They had that in the 3DS in Samus Returns. Where you can very use like nice. The circle pad to do that.
So yeah, very nice.
Oh, it's I'm so happy it's back. It's,
targeting
perfect.
An enemy.
Yes.
Make that sound. I just want to take a moment.
I'm sure as someone who's only played Super, you're like, oh my god, look at all these features.
Yeah, so no, good. So legit. 19 years. And you know, having only played an hour of Super as well.
A lot of years. We've been waiting for this for a long time, so we're really excited.
Yeah, we have. We've been waiting a long time. Yep. Also, Advance Wars has been like almost as long though. Like
that's true. Yeah, yeah.
Metroid Samus Returns.
Although, Days of Ruin was really good. If you ever played it, I don't know if you did.
Oh, I haven't played any Advance Wars.
That's oh, at like, all. Oh.
I was gonna emulate, but
yeah. Days of Ruin is excellent. That's like a kind of like darker, more serious reimagining. That was really cool. It was like post-apocalyptic, very interesting.
Yeah, my friend said he didn't like it because it was darker, but like, I've heard it was good.
Yeah, but both styles work for it, I think. It
doesn't break.
I love just the dash uppercut cut. That's so sick.
Counter and immediate damage to an enemy. Yeah, something this game does really well.
Samus doing more physical attacks is always great. Just punch them.
Oh yeah, well, because like, yeah, my main exposure to her is Smash, and like, she does plenty of hand-to-hand combat in Smash, so it's like, it just seems appropriate.
Instead of having to stand still and wait for enemies to attack you, you can just go get them, which
I'm gonna get every little corner of that map.
No, for sure.
I love that. Like, Samus moves so well, and she's
I just abuse parry in that game, because I play Fallen Order, and parrying is in my blood now.
Ah, yeah, there you go.
Samus in a really long time. Absolutely, and you've opened up the map screen here.
R says, I made it up to the final mission of Days of Ruin.
Ooh.
Is that one really hard?
Yeah, it's pretty tough. I mean, most Advance Wars, the final mission is brutal. So, we'll see how that gameplay carries over into the new one, if they've made any difficulty changes. You look or the, at the map, for the remake anyway.
Areas that you haven't been to yet or aren't able to access yet, you try and find another way through, find a new ability, nice. Push your way forward.
Oh, very Hollow Knight.
Lather, rinse, repeat. So that's back and
this map looks very Metroid 2 and not interconnected like 3 and 4.
I haven't discovered yet.
I'm wondering if it's just because it's an early area or if they'll get more interconnected later.
Maybe, yeah. Maybe we're in like tutorialization zone here a little bit.
Could be.
Don't sleep on those markers. Those can be really important in this labyrinthine world. Sure. But this looks curious.
Just the animations look so really, nice.
A part great. Of the charm of Metroid, though, having this. Renewed sense of purpose in your backtrack.
Oh yeah, they don't even have a single extra energy tank. This has to be the beginning.
Pinpoint is the amount of work the dev team put in Samus.
Oh look, she like pushes on the walls.
Yeah, exactly. Of
gripping the walls.
I wish Samus would push against me.
Like, oh my god.
Yeah, you'll notice.
Put her hand on me and shove me out of the way.
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, cool. Oh, and here's the thing.
Okay. Yeah, you can see all the like the fibers on the suit on her back.
Little moments like this when you're in helmet view for a moment so really beautiful. Add to the isolation and the tone of this game.
I'm so glad that it's got this horror aspect to it now.
Sequel to Metroid Fusion, but you can see that her suit looks a little bit different than that. So
perfect. That'll be just what I wanted.
Moment that people will find out
beautiful.
And, when they play the game. We don't want to spoil too much.
Yeah, please do not spoil too much.
These are the Emmy that Sakamoto-san was talking about, and none of Samus's weapons seem to do anything against them.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, yeah, she kicks it.
Oh, that slide move is so cool.
She looks so cool when she's sliding.
Yep, it is. Nope. Okay.
Oh, no, just no.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I love that it'll follow you between rooms. That is so cool.
Oh, my gosh.
So scary. About this being called Dread.
Yeah, that walk, like you were saying, that walk looks just...
They're very relentless.
Oh, my... Okay. Oh, wow.
Like, it, like, reaches up and, like, latches onto shit. Oh, I hate that.
For me there.
It's trying to climb with the arm it doesn't have.
That's... Oh, I... That's awesome. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's a nice detail.
A bit damaged and can't completely reach to me, but we're gonna have to find a different way to tackle that enemy.
You know, this thing is a central unit, which
it's like the Terminator, man.
Various areas of the planet.
Yeah, sort of seriously.
Biomechanical.
They're taking back one of the best parts of Fusion.
Maybe similar units.
Ooh.
Metroid games, and from this unit, Samus can power up, get a temporary power up for her arm cannon, and turn it into the Omega cannon.
Oh, interesting. Temporary upgrades. Okay.
Yeah. In typical 2D Metroid fashion, we've always seen the camera like panned around here and...
Wait, sorry, I was looking at my phone. What was that about the temporary upgrades?
She got a temp upgrade off of this core unit that turned it into the Omega Blaster.
Which is so cool.
Oh.
Yeah, little additions like that
look
really
at
flesh
it.
Out the classic 2D gameplay without it feeling like it's too far from what we talked about it. Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's something you can actually fight the thing with.
Yeah, possibly.
Epic says, I'll allow Samus simping. Well, good, because that's kind of my shtick.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
You see my Twitter and the stuff I draw. It's a lot of Samus.
Yep. See you later, Gray. Thanks for hanging out, bud. Glad you enjoyed.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
In order to take that Emmy down, our...
It looks like I was right. She did use the thing to, reverting to regular arm cannon.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's like, you kind of have to find your way through the area to get the upgrade so you can deal with the Emmy. At least in that area.
I also want to point out while you're scrolling your way through
that looks nice.
Different halls, but there are so many different ways to play.
Is this
game.
A map station or a save?
Amazing.
Are those Chozo statues?
Queen of the missiles,
that's a save. Okay.
You can also just
that room is so cool looking.
Cannon. You can try and avoid enemies altogether. Try and hit them all. Really, it's up to you.
Charge me for
what
that.
Samus, you want to be.
Yeah, and
you have the gravity suit for that.
As Audrey
right?
pointed out too earlier, that you use.
Aim. I want to see her jump. I want to see how high she gets out of water.
You could also just
I like too that you can see like
while you're moving as well.
Like as she's like standing and shooting up, like you can see like her legs bracing the shots. That's such a nice detail.
We got water physics.
I see a pixelated door, and now I'm filled with dread.
Don't touch it.
Fog gate.
Entries to the
walks on
various
zones. Yeah. Oh my god.
And once interesting.
You smash my there, two favorite games together.
Seriously. For those.
Oh.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. Oh, I'm all about that. That's big.
So that is, yeah, that is a quick idea. One, I mean, Ben certainly thinks so, that Nintendo one. I'm pretty high on it as well.
Nintendo one.
I am very impressed. Yeah, I'm very, very impressed. They saved E3. I still maintain that Microsoft had an excellent conference as well, but this and Microsoft are probably the only good conferences.
Yeah, Microsoft was all right. even if a lot of the games are stuff I'm not personally interested in, it's like... had a good presentation.
Right. Yeah, and there was a bunch of stuff there that I was interested in, which is why I'm higher on it. Look at this. Oh, ew! I hate that! Oh, I hate that! Oh, God.
Oh. It's so animated that deserves a raise.
Oh, it's so scuttly.
You gotta get away.
It's so smooth.
Yeah, when they go into the patrol mode and turn red, the door locks until they sort of lose track of you.
It's still
looking around, but
God, I'm so excited for this game.
Yeah. Also, I don't know if it's my heart throbbing through my hands or
that's so sick.
Oh my God, look at outside.
Oh, look at the little boy in the background.
Terrifying.
Little dude.
Yeah, team makes
a couple of
them. I've seen like artists make stuff like this of like what would it be like a big 3D environment in a Metroid. Like look at.
Do you want to point out like
obviously Prime, but like
right.
The development team has put into like not just the enemies in the forefront, but also in the background. I don't know if you guys can tell the shimmering thing.
I thought this was gonna be a
DS
game.
Oh, ew. It
doesn't bode well.
Oh.
Yeah. Well,
invisibility.
Oh, I hated that.
Yeah, some of those details kind of tell the story as effectively as, you know, a voiceover or anything.
Yeah, if you want to be a bounty hunter, you have to pay attention to details.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's the thing she can grab.
And watch out for gooey enemies.
Does she have that ability yet?
yeah, I guess not. More missiles. Of,
like, the rib
that one was free. It's just sitting there.
So, the thing about Metroid enemies
background
too,
animal
is that
best boy,
some of them
yeah.
have patterns and you can counter them, and others don't, like this one. So I'm
just
gonna move him out of the way so I can use it.
Ooh, the dark, that was nice.
This room is a communication room with
Adam. Yeah, it's really dark.
Who happens to be that. Samus's.
God, what if they have a whole area with the lights
PC
off?
Oh man, and you just like navigate by Samus's suit lights.
Wait.
But Dan, if you could summarize
what just happened there,
I just brought back a character that I wasn't expecting to see there for a second.
I'm looking back at the replay.
Little analysis.
Adam from the AI from Fusion.
Ah, okay. Or anything like that. Interesting. Okay.
Holy
shit.
Afros are back.
There's some interesting lore in there, and
this is seriously a Fusion sequel. I can't believe it.
That's so super cool.
And in that one. Adam,
I'm so happy for you, dude. I mean, again, I'm excited, let alone you. I don't have the emotional connection to this that you do.
Have a patrolling a zone and also how dangerous they are, which we've kind of
that's
seen.
Insane.
Hopefully we won't see too much firsthand here.
Also, you can see T doing a great job of just shooting
hello.
The environment.
How are you, Sarita?
Looking for a
oh, world. Hello.
It's not always going to be
don't mind us, we're just really completely geeking out over Metroid right now.
It's not just exploration.
Yeah, because the direct is over, it was great. Now we're watching the treehouse stuff.
Yeah, and it's really cool, too, how Metroid Dread does this really sweet balance of, you know,
like
the moments
dark
where
it is.
You're allowed to have, like, some quiet to... solving puzzles, and then it's interspersed with this really
interesting,
heavy, intense action.
Yeah. So oh! God, I hate the way the Emmys move.
That was the Emmy.
It's not like gigantic. It's like just bigger than you, but also big enough to be threatening.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Which is marked with blue.
Just so slick.
The area.
It's so intense.
Like, oh boy!
Chase with,
so fast.
With it. Oh god!
I'm glad you're faster than it, because Jesus.
It has Samus on eyesight. It turns red, which is the chase.
Oh!
So yellow is it's heard a noise or sensed a vibration, and it's gonna go.
Oh, it can sense vibrations. What?
Oh, oh my god!
No.
Oh!
Is the game over? Yeah, so, oh my god.
The Emmy.
Wow.
Cool that that.
Just
pretty
instant death.
It is sort of like a permadeath, which is
goddamn
unusual for enemies with in the Metroid series. But luckily, it's not very... the game's pretty forgiving. It allows you to respawn
is key
in
this game. Yeah, it seems like it.
In recently, so
yeah, for sure, for sure. Yeah, you need to have a mastery of the movement so you can keep navigating around them.
Yeah, as T said, insta-kill is new to the series, but it's really great because it offers a chance for you to have that challenging difficulty that I think Metroid...
I mean, people are already making fan art.
Dude, I believe it.
...with the respawning that you just have to play the whole game to get back to where you are, so it's a really wonderful balance.
Yeah, and when
also people are memeing about Tekken, Kazuya just throwing Smash characters.
Yeah, of course, of course. How could you not?
That kind of got, like, at least for me personally, that kind of got just, like, blown out by this.
Oh, well, yeah, I completely forgot that that was even a thing, but.
And then if they see something in eyesight, then they'll go chase it.
Oh, cool.
This is such a small but really neat touch. The way that Samus moves slower in the water.
Yeah, and the audio change, too. Yeah.
That's really nice.
I like the audio change. I mean, they're kind of treating it like a big deal. She always moves slow in water, but
that one straggler there.
I'm so glad the little edge grab thing is back.
I'm feeling brave.
Yeah, that's nice. There's just every
kill horror, yeah.
Every little detail that we're seeing here is so cool. There's just so much attention to everything. Yeah, it's really, really nice.
You don't have to stop to fight these enemies. If you really master that dash melee, you can just kind of run and gun.
Mm-hmm. I'm by no means like a speedrunner, but like I hope they it seems like they kept that them in mind.
Love the animation of the water.
Kind of can't make a 2D Metroid without people speedrunning the hell out of it.
Right. Yeah, that's yeah.
Okay, so they brought the water in the air place, and then they have to go back. Yeah. Nice.
And here is
God, I love the bathroom. Suit. Like the suit lights in a dark room is just so cool.
This room will grant me more visibility to the area.
Also the white, like she hasn't really had a white suit since Prime 2.
So we sort of lightly
Yeah, that's cool.
The colors look so good.
The
oh my gosh,
the game, which occurs
wow.
Post Metroid Fusion. And so that's why Samus's look looks different, but also to point out back to Audrey's point about, you know, the game is about exploration and action, and so this area
people were saying for like years and years, like what's she gonna look like in potential Metroid 5
see that there's still a lot
after
of
fusion
obscurity here, and so
because her suit like permanently changes in that game.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize it was like a permanent thing. Gotcha.
Secrets involved.
Yeah. She gets attacked by like a parasite, and they had to do like an operation on her.
Okay.
That's how she ends up with that. You're a new or fusion suit.
Metroid fan, okay. Okay.
If you've never played a Metroid game before, it really gets you up to speed with anything you need to know to enjoy the story.
Is that why there's like the sort of organic muscle fibery looking stuff on the suit? You think?
I think so. Yeah, because the fusion suit was also like it wasn't like armor. It was like very.
We've been waiting a long time for this.
I don't know, stretchy.
Yeah. That's what I've seen. Like. From screenshots of the game and everything I've seen, it didn't look like armor. It looked like some sort of more like bio suit.
Yeah,
like even those. Oh, cool.
A boon because it grants you replenishment.
Even though like it was like a pixel game, like if you just stopped and paused, you could like kind of see her breathing animation.
Oh, that's cool.
With it was really nice. I didn't expect the Emmy to be right on top of me when I destroy the Autools.
That little beeping sound, just I hear it in my nightmares now.
They always come up with...
Oh, he's persistent. It's persistent.
Very
convenient.
Is it going to come in with her, though?
An interesting detail about this game is normally in Metroid games, you start at the surface of the planet and you work your way
What's
deeper.
That funky little dude
game,
down there?
You actually start deep within the planet.
Oh, it's like an energy recharge. Okay.
And so
it's a recharge.
That yearning towards ascension really adds to the tone of
the
game.
Oh, look at this
well.
Guy.
He's just vibing.
Why is she just running in? Okay.
Goodbye. He's gone now.
I also love that you don't have to necessarily wait for an enemy to attack in order to counter in this game. If you keep an eye out, you can actually sometimes counter before they start their attack.
Here's a throwback. Oh, cool. So I have to use a missile in order to destroy that cover.
Oh yeah, missile doors.
Swapping back and forth. Okay.
Oh.
I love that dynamic zoom in though when she does like the counter thing at the right time.
Right. There, that's super cool.
Yeah.
That's oh yeah, I wonder what the timings and stuff on that are.
Is it, if you use that on an enemy, you will get, I think, a few more.
Air beam.
Instant kills out of the heart. Water animations are neat. It looks like she's actually pushing to walk through the water. Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Very iconic to the Metroid series. So Samus.
Oh, cool. It gives like a little tutorialization thing too. Nice.
Oh, they've never had that before.
That's nice. And I love, like, there's been a lot of indie games I've seen that do that where they like have a little animation of it going too, so you know what you're looking for. Very nice. Very nice.
You weren't able to before.
Yeah, and suit upgrades are another classic part of Metroid gameplay that is
alive
and well
in this game.
Oh,
that's cool looking.
That's really cool.
You can see if you keep an eye on the background.
It almost looks like the same shoulder cauldron she has.
Cool, yeah, you know, you're right.
It really piques your curiosity.
Is that, do we know where her like original suit and everything came from? Like, did she get it from, like?
Yeah, she got it from the Chozo.
She did. Okay.
Yeah.
I love that too. Mm-hmm. Using the charge beam to make a charge beam spin attack and defeat some of those enemies.
Oh,
well, there was a Chozo statue here on this planet, which means like they got to be around.
Right. Did you hear what they said about the charge beam spin attack?
Always a plus for me.
Oh yeah. Wait. Is it? Did they say it's like it kills the enemies? Like it doesn't either.
Well, they said like you can use a charge beam and then go into a spin attack to like throw the beam or something. I don't know, it was weird, but, like, yeah, she was able to, like, charge it up and then spin, and, like, it sent out a wave or something like that.
Oh, nice. Sorry, yeah, I totally missed that.
You know these abilities and become adept at them, you start to feel like Samus.
I love just the idea of smacking someone with the arm cannon. It's so satisfying looking. Oh, look at that. Oh! Dude. Adding a parry system to this is so, so legit.
It's awesome. These poor slug boys.
They're just vibing, and Samus just comes through like, whap!
Punch, you are now dust.
Pounch!
You're now just a pile of goop.
So now we can't go through this area because of the water, so we're not able to slide. But we are able to access this door that we weren't to before. Ah, and here's another Emmy door. But in order to not spoil any more surprises here.
They're stopping here.
Fair.
All right. Well, that's all we've got on Metroid Dread for now. Thanks, Teresa, Audrey. Next up, we've got some Mario Party Superstars to show you.
Oh. Well, is there anything else that we would want to see from the Nintendo Treehouse stuff, Ben, or should we call it here? What do you think?
I've got everything I've wanted and more.
Yeah, and I think I'm good.
Mario Party's good, but
Mario Party's great and all, but the only other thing I would really care to see anything else of is Advance Wars, and I mean, it's just going to be the graphical improvements, basically, so, like, I'm probably good. I think I'm comfortable calling it here, so. What a show.
I'm so happy we streamed it. I'm so happy, like, some big pop-offs happened.
Dude, like, some massive pop-offs. Actual insane stuff. So, guys in the chat, thanks for hanging out. I hope you had a good time, because we certainly did, as I'm sure you can tell. And then the only other thing I can ask for is sometime in the future, some extra Fire Emblem and Triangle Strategy news, which will come. It'll come.
Oh, we'll get some.
Anything you want to say before we close out here, Ben?
I'm just kind of blown away by Metroid 5. And Advance Wars 2. One and two. Oh
yeah. God. Yeah. Yeah. It's absolutely insane. So, all right, guys. Thanks for hanging out. I will be back with some sort of content sometime in the near future. As stated in my update video, I have a lot going on coming up, but you'll see some stuff from me. And, well, I hope you enjoy whatever is left of E3, but we're going to call it here. So, Ben, thank you for joining me.
Thank you for having me, Tom.
Absolutely. And we will talk to you guys next time. Be good to each other, guys. Bye for now.